food and putting it in the hands of hungry people, and we'll tally up the cost of all those gifts in that famous song, The 12 Days of Christmas. But first, Bossa Nova Robotics, a Pittsburgh startup that's begun to deploy shelf-scanning robots in big box retail. And Sergeant Staff is back with us. He's co-founder and CTO of Bossa Nova. Welcome. Good to have you.
Thank you very much. Glad to be here.
Yeah, this is pretty sophisticated stuff. We should mention, though, because we had Bossa Nova on the program many years ago.
That's right.
And you were actually starting out making toy robots. A lot more sophisticated than this one, for sure, but that's kind of where you got your start, right?
That's right. That's right. So we did robot toys in the first half-life, if you will, of Bossa Nova. And now our toys have grown, both in size, complexity, and we're deploying them in retail stores. So what we're doing now is we're scanning products on shelves with fully autonomous robots. Maybe one way to think about them is like indoor self-driving cars. And we take high-resolution pictures of every product, and then we use AI to analyze what's on the shelf and what's missing. And we inform the store whenever they have out of stock, whenever the price is incorrect, and we tell them where the location of the products are.
But the whole idea here, this is not something that has to happen in the middle of the night. These robots can be sharing the aisles with all of us when we're shopping?
And that's very, very exciting for us because, absolutely, yes, we're deploying robots during business hours around shoppers. Shoppers are encountering them every day, and it's very, very exciting for one, because the robots are being exposed to so many people, and people in return are also figuring out how they behave around robots. But also from the business side, the retailers need the robots to be there just before the next wave of shoppers. So we do it at night, we have to do it, you know, before breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Inventory is changing all day long,
all day
right?
Long.
What's available on the shelf.
Right.
And the difference is, I mean, these are not like, obviously this is a toy, but there's no robot engineer walking around behind this thing with a remote control, right?
Correct.
They're like really autonomous.
They're fully autonomous. They have a bubble of safety around them. They detect all obstacles with 3D sensors. Don't touch and don't collide into people, don't touch anything. So they're very, very safe, and they also know where they are, they know where to go, and they know what to scan.
Wow, and so it's really a step above. We're also proud here in Pittsburgh of our self-driving cars
that
we're seeing on the streets, but there you've got at least two guys in every vehicle, two people keeping it safe. This is the next level of autonomy in some ways.
Yeah, being indoors simplifies a little bit the problem. You know, we're not barreling down at 60 miles an hour and risk killing anyone. The robot moves in a very paced speed, and with that safety all around it, it is safe to have the humans removed from it.
Yeah, so how did you make the switch from doing the toy thing to then the company saying, no, there's really a big opportunity in scanning shelves in retail stores?
Yeah, so we always wanted to put robots into people's lives, and toys were kind of the beginning for us, and we wanted to go higher technology, higher end, because it played better to our robotics roots and the engineers and the scientists we had on staff. And when we knocked on the door of retailers, asking them whether they would want robots around people, they are the ones who guided us towards that inventory problem that they wanted to fix. And so it was really an eye-opening event for us. And by giving them eyes on the shelf, we allow them to dramatically improve the efficiency of the store and therefore better serve their customers.
And so their challenge had to be having enough people all the time, checking the shelves on a regular enough basis, and then the monotony of trying to see how many cans of soup are there here and how many boxes of that over there.
It's a little bit counterintuitive. You would think that what comes from the truck and what sells from the front of the store, you do the subtraction and you know what's left in the store. It turns out you have tens of thousands of products coming in every night through the trucks, and you're fighting the clock to put them on the shelf. And every time a human touches the product, they can make a mistake, and those mistakes accumulate, and the inventory system actually gets distorted. So what we do by putting cameras on products and eyes on the shelf is we really help them improve the accuracy of the inventory. And you can think about shoppers actually picking up a product and then changing their mind and then putting it somewhere else, or children actually messing around with the shelves.
Sure. Well, and I imagine because the margins are so thin in retail,
right. Yes.
That just a little bit out of kilter can really add up over time.
Absolutely. And right now, retail is really going towards this omni-channel experience where you buy online, you pick up in the store. But if you bought it online and they promise you that you will find it, and you go to the store and not find it, you're going to be very upset. So they are really very keen on knowing what's in the store and what's not, so that they can open up this new wave of retail.
Well, I hadn't thought about that integration with the online presence,
right.
And being able to use the stores to sort of be the warehouse and hold the inventory, but
for
they
got
to know that for sure that the product is sitting there. So where are you deploying these? How far are you right now in terms of commercializing this?
So we announced that we're deploying 50 stores with Walmart, and that's going very, very well. And it's all over the country. We're East Coast, West Coast, Center, everywhere.
That's amazing, which means that from your small operation here in Pittsburgh, and I guess your headquarters in San Francisco on the West Coast, you're going to have more people, I would assume, if you're nationwide.
Yes, yes, absolutely. So we're well capitalized. We announced that we raised about $41 million so far, and we are rapidly growing. And we're looking for all kinds of talent, particularly in robotics, autonomy, artificial intelligence, cloud, hardware, software, you name it. And if I may have one plug, I think it's exciting to work for us because unlike some self-driving cars, our robots are deployed now. So there is a direct impact, an immediate impact for that work.
That's really exciting. Well, hopefully you'll find plenty of people who will want to do this kind of work right here in Pittsburgh. It is so cool that you guys started here and you're building this business out of our region. Sarjun Scott from Bossa Nova Robotics. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Next up, music.